الحمد لله الذي أرسل رسوله بالهدى والدين الحق ليظهره على الدين كله وكفى بالله شهيدا أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له إقرارا به وتوحيدا وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما مزيدا Inshallah ta'ala, I'll start with a brief piece of advice to myself and likewise to the brothers and the sisters, especially in the time that we live. Because the believer living in the world today finds that there are many challenges before them in order to remain firm upon the Book of Allah and the Sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Alhamdulillah, the people that are able, with the tawfiq of Allah Azza wa Jalla Tabaraka wa Ta'ala, to provide the information that is required to remain firm in such times, is the people of the Sunnah and the Jama'ah. Allah Azza wa Jalla Tabaraka wa Ta'ala, He said, هو الذي بعث في الأميين رسولا منهم يتلو عليهم آياته ويزكيهم ويعلمهم الكتاب والحكمة وإن كانوا من قبل لفي ضلال مبين. If we look at this verse, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He tells us that He sent to those who are unlettered a messenger from themselves. A messenger from themselves who recited to them the verses of Allah Azza wa Jalla. And that is why, brothers and sisters, our methodology, the methodology of the people of the Sunnah, is based upon what Shaykh al-Albani rahimahullah ta'ala and others used to refer to as at-tasfiyah wa tarbiyah, purification and cultivation. Purification, making sure that our beliefs are correct, making sure that our worship is correct, making sure that our character is in accordance to the Qur'an and the Sunnah. Making sure that our business dealings are in accordance to the Qur'an and the Sunnah. Making sure that what we find in the books of knowledge is in accordance to the book and the Sunnah. And we see in that verse, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He sent the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam reciting the ayat of Allah azza wa jalla. Reciting the verses of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Highlighting the importance, brothers and sisters, for all of us to learn. To take time to learn our religion. Even if it is only a small amount. Even if it is one lesson a week. Even if we memorize a number of verses in a given period of time or a number of ahadith. Lima the wine. Because we want to ascertain whether our worship is correct. Am I making wudu correctly? Am I praying correctly? Am I fasting correctly? Am I giving zakat correctly? And so on and so forth. Is my belief correct? My belief in Allah Azza wa Jalla, is it correct? My belief in the books, is it correct? My belief in the angels, is it correct? My belief in the messengers, is it correct? My belief in the last day, is it correct? My belief in the divine decree, is it correct? We have to take time to learn. Allah Azza wa Jalla, He sent the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam recited the ayat of Allah Azza wa Jalla, purifying them and teaching them the kitab and al-hikmah, the Qur'an and the sunnah. Imam al-Shafi'i rahimahullah, he said when we find in the Qur'an al-hikmah mentioned along with the book, it's referring to the sunnah. That was the da'wah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. That was the da'wah, Qur'an and sunnah, that's it. Nothing else, revelation from Allah azza wa jalla. And if you look, alhamdulillah, that's what the companions, they learn from the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam. The tabi'un, they learn from the companions. The atba' tabi'in, they learn from the students of the companions. And the isnad, that chain, it continued in that fashion. They didn't come with anything new. If you look at the Imam al-Islam, the scholars of hadith in the Kutub al-Sunan, we find ayat and ahadith. Now, collections of ahadith, but even if you look in Bukhari, he mentions ayat from the book of Allah Azza wa Jal. And this continued up until today. That the da'wah, our da'wah, the da'wah of the people of Sunnah is based upon knowledge. There's no shortcut. We see what happens when people try to take shortcuts. Instead of learning, like we find the scholars of Islam teaching and promoting education, learning the religion, some people, they try and take shortcuts. Rebelling against the ruler, they try and take that shortcut. It results in chaos and commotion and destruction. And look at the state of many of the Muslim countries in the world today. Some people, they try and take shortcuts. Instead of learning, taking the time to learn and being patient in the sittings of knowledge, they want entertainment. So they go to anashis, or they go to the spoken word, or so on and so forth. In reality, there is only one path that leads to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and that is the path that was clarified by Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. قُلْ هَذِهِ سَبِيلِ أَدْعُوا إِلَى اللَّهِ عَلَى بَصِيرًا. Say, this is my path, I call to Allah upon knowledge, upon insight. And da'wah, calling to Allah Azza wa Jalla, is ibadah, is worship. Calling to Allah Azza wa Jalla is worship. And worship, we know, has to meet two conditions. The first is ikhlas, sincerity, and then in accordance to the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. If it is not in accordance to the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, even though the person may intend well, then it is going to be considered to be an innovation. And that is something we cannot change, nor do we apologize for. If giving da'wah, no matter who it is done in a manner that opposes the way of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, then it is considered to be an innovation and misguidance. Allah Azza wa Jalla said about the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, يُعَلِّمُهُمُ الْكِتَابَ وَالْحِكْمَةِ. He taught them the Qur'an and the Sunnah. Abu Hurairah radiallahu anhu, that is what he memorized from the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. أَكْثَرَ مَاذَا فِي رِوَايَةِ الْحَدِيثِ. He narrated many ahadith from the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. المكثرون في رواية الأثر أبو هريرة يليه ابن عمر إلى آخر يعني الشعر. Those Sahaba known as المكثرون في الرواية. What did they memorize? Ahadith from the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. So if we want to be successful wherever we are, wherever we live, whether we live in Africa, whether we live in Europe, whether we live in the Middle East, whether we live in Europe or anywhere else in the world, the same thing applies. Our da'wah has to be built upon knowledge. At-tasfiyah wa tarbiyah. And then implementation of that knowledge. Because yes, knowledge alone is not sufficient. Rather, there has to be implementation. And if we notice that there is a deficiency, it returns back to one of these two things. Either al-quwa al-ilmiyah or al-quwa al-amaliyah. Either knowledge or implementation. And brothers and sisters, this, it requires patience. Because it may be that, alhamdulillah, a person, walillah alhamd, indahu al-ilm al-sahih. A person may have correct knowledge. A person may have correct actions. And they call to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. However, people do not respond to them. People do not answer that call. What is upon the person? To be patient, a sabr. وَاسْتَعِينُوا بِاللَّهِ وَاسْبِرُوا. Seek the aid of Allah Azza wa Jalla and be patient. Success, it comes from Allah Azza wa Jalla. Regardless of whether the people, they respond or they don't respond, continue to teach. And you will see the benefits of your call. But some people, yes, they start off. Because the road could be long. The road, it could be a long journey. It could take a lot of time. It may take 10 years, may take 15 years, maybe 20, maybe 30. It may not happen in your lifetime. Shaykh al-Islam ibn Taymiyyah rahimahullah, he died in prison. He was in the sijin. Remember that. So you may not even see the fruits in your lifetime, but look how many people benefit today from the books of Shaykh al-Islam ibn Taymiyyah rahimahullah ta'ala. How many people continue to benefit and read his books? So it is upon the caller and upon the student, it is upon the teacher, it is upon the learner to be patient. Even if you, at one point in time, you may feel lonely, or you may feel, for example, that the masses are against you, and so on and so forth. وَاسْتَعِينُوا بِاللَّهِ وَاسْبِرُوا. Seek the aid of Allah Azza wa Jal and be patient. Why? Because inevitably, you want the reward from Allah Azza wa Jal, and you want Allah to be pleased with you. No, you don't care what the people they think about you if you are sticking to what Allah Azza wa Jal has commanded you. And Allah Azza wa Jal, He says in the Quran, يَنْصُرْكُمُ اللَّهُ فَلَا غَالِبَ لَكُمْ. If Allah aids you, no one can overcome you. If Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala aids you, then nobody can overcome you. فَلَا غَالِبَ لَكُمْ. If Allah azza wa jalla grants you success, then nobody can stop you, nobody can hinder you. And that is why again, alhamdulillah, a person doesn't say, well, they control everything. They have all the masajid. They have all of this. They have, for example, X amount of subscribers. They have this type of capability. La. The person that has trusted Allah Azza wa Jal knows firmly, إِيَنْصُرْكُمُ اللَّهُ فَلَا غَالِبَ لَكُمْ وَإِنْ يَخْذُلْكُمْ فَمَنْ ذَا الَّذِي يَنْصُرُكُمْ مِنْ بَعْدِهِ وَعَلَى اللَّهِ فَلْيَتَوَكَّلِ الْمُؤْمِنُونَ. Allah says in the Quran, if Allah gives you victory, nobody can overcome. If Allah forsakes you, then who is going to give you victory and aid you? And the believers should place their trust in Allah Azza wa Jalla. So even Ya Abdullah, Ya Amatullah, if you find that you are one, that you are alone, and there is no one else in your city or your village, but alhamdulillah, you have learned from the book of Allah and the Sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and you understand the fundamentals of the people of the Sunnah, walillahilhamd walminna, and you start by teaching the people, alhamdulillah, be certain that the promise of Allah azza wa jalla is true. If Allah azza wa jalla aids you, then no one can overcome you. And if Allah azza wa jalla forsakes you, then nobody can aid you. And the believers, they should put their trust in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And look at the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and look at what he experienced and what he went through. What do you think about us? So alhamdulillah, I know we were a bit delayed, ikhwan, and I know that there are some questions, inshallah ta'ala. I just wanted to remind myself and my brothers, and likewise the sisters, because sometimes, no doubt, a person may lose heart. You see, you know, especially in this time, kathratu a'da, you see the large number of the enemies of the people of the Sunnah, and you see them يجتمعون في حرب السنة وأهلها, uniting to wage a war against the Sunnah and the people of the Sunnah, and a person may, for example, feel sad, but in reality, the one who has understanding of the religion of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he should not feel sorrow, nor should he feel sad. Rather, they should be patient and they should continue propagating that, alhamdulillah, Allah Azza wa Jalla has blessed them to learn of the book of Allah and the Sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So alhamdulillah, some of the brothers, they wrote some questions. I don't know if there's any others that have been written. One of the questions here is something that many times people, they ask about, and they say the Salafis never talk about the mistakes of the Muslim rulers, and they defend them, even though they have evil in their countries. Firstly and foremostly, Allah Azza wa Jal, He said in the Quran, إِنَّ اللَّهَ يَأْمُرُ بِالْعَدْلِ وَالْإِحْسَانِ وَإِيْتَاءِ ذِي الْقُرْبَى وَيَنْهَى عَنِ الْفَحْشَاءِ وَالْمُنْكَرِ وَالْبَغْيِ يَعِذُكُمْ لَعَلَّكُمْ تَذَكَّرُونَ. Allah Azza wa Jal, He commands us with justice, fairness, and ihsan, and keeping relations with one's family. And Allah prohibits indecency, immorality, and evil, and transgression. Ibn Mas'ud radiallahu anhu said,
This verse, أَجْمَعُ آيَةٍ فِي الْقُرْآنِ. It is the most comprehensive verse in the Qur'an. This verse is the most comprehensive verse in the Qur'an. When we speak, we have to be just. And that's something, brothers and sisters, we need. نُرَبِّ أَنفُسَنَا وَغَيْرَنَا. We have to nurture ourselves and others upon this, to be just. When we speak for those who are close to us, or we speak against those who are considered to be our enemy, we have to be just. Allah Azza wa Jalla Tabaraka wa Ta'ala, and this is the way of the people of the Sunnah, in the past and the present, they are just. If, for example, your enemy lies upon you, it is not allowed for you to lie upon them. If, for example, in qadhafa, if they accuse you of zina, you cannot make qadh as it relates to them. If they transgress against your family, it doesn't allow you to transgress against theirs. Rather, Allah Azza wa Jalla commands us to be just at all times. Allah Azza wa Jalla said in the Quran, لَا يَجْهِمَنَّكُمْ شَنَآنُ قَوْمٍ أَنْ صَدُّوكُمْ عَنِ الْمَسْجِدِ الْحَرَامِ أَنْ تَعْتَدُوا وَتَعَاوَنُوا عَلَى الْبِرِّ وَالتَّقْوَى وَلَا تَعَاوَنُوا عَلَى الْإِثْمِ وَالْعُدْوَانِ. Do not let the dislike of a people because they prevented you from a masjid al-haram. Do not transgress against them. That's referring to non-Muslims. What do you think about the Muslims? That is about non-Muslims. Allah Azza wa Jal, the fact that they prevented the Muslims from going to a masjid al-haram, still Allah Azza wa Jal, He said, do not transgress against them. So what do you think about your Muslim brother or your Muslim sister? That is why the ulama of tafsir, if you go back to Adwar al-Bayan al-Shanqiti rahimahullah, al-Allama al-Shanqiti, he said that's a clear proof that what? مَنْ عَصَى اللَّهَ فِينَا. Whoever disobeys Allah as it relates to us, نُطِيعَ اللَّهَ فِيهِمْ. Then still we obey Allah as it relates to them. So if they lie upon us, still, we don't lie against them. If they slander us, we cannot slander them. And if a person lays that as a foundation, because when you refute or when you correct religious errors, it has to be based upon what? Al-ilm wal-adl. It has to be based upon knowledge, and it has to be based upon fairness. When you speak about al-a'rad, when you speak about people's honor, it has to be based upon al-ilm wal-adl, knowledge and justice. And the Shaykh al-Islam Ibn Taymiyyah mentioned, rahimahullah, that there's a right that belongs to Allah Azza wa Jalla as it relates to that matter, min hayth al-wilaya wal-adawa, and there's a right as it relates to the rights of the human. So we have to be just, we have to speak with knowledge. Firstly, this claim that the Salafis defend the rulers even though they have evil in their countries. The Salafis don't defend any evil. هذا كذب. That's a lie. هاتوا برهانكم إن كنتم صادقين. Provide for us your proof if you are truthful. And we'll say, where did the scholars or the callers of Salafiyyah defend evil, munkar? How is it possible? Give us an example. Rather, what you find the people of the Sunnah, like, do you accuse al-Tahawi rahimahullah of the same thing when he said, "La nara al-khuruj ala a'immatina wa walati umurina wa injaru"? He said, we do not believe that it is permissible to rebel against our rulers and our leaders, even if they are oppressive. Do you accuse Tahawi of that? And we could continue to give other statements of the Imams of the past. From the Imam of Islam, he said, وَلَا نَدْعُ عَلَيْهِمْ. We don't supplicate against them. وَلَا نَنْزَعُ يَدًا مِنْ طَاعَةٍ. Nor do we disobey them. We do not remove our hand from obeying them. Why? He said, because we see that obeying them is from obeying Allah Azza wa Jalla. Because Allah commanded us to obey them with what? مَا لَمْ يَأْمُرُوا بِمَعَصِيَةٍ. As long as they do not command us to disobey Allah Azza wa Jalla. Give us one example. Rather, the position of the people of the Sunnah is based upon the instructions of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He is the one who said, "Yakunu ba'di a'imma." There will be leaders. There will be rulers after me. He said, لَا يَهْتَدُونَ بِهُدَايَ. They don't follow my guidance. لَا يَسْتَنُونَ بِسُنَّتِي. They do not implement my sunnah. There will be among them men, قُلُوبُهُمْ قُلُوبُ الشَّيَاطِينَ فِي جُثْمَانِ إِنْسٍ. They will have the hearts of devils in the bodies of men. They said to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, كَيْفَ أَصْنَعْ يَا رَسُولُ اللَّهِ إِنَ أَدْرَكْتُ ذَلِكَ. How shall I behave if I reach that time, O Messenger of Allah? He said, تَسْمَعُ وَتُطِيعُ لِلْأَمِيرِ. He said, you hear and you obey the ruler. That's the guidance of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Then he said, وَإِنْ أُخِذَ وَإِنْ ضُرِبَ ظَهْرُ وَأُخِذَ مَالُ فَاسْمَعْ وَأَطِيعُ. He emphasized it a second time. He said, even if they flood your backs, even if they take your wealth, he said, listen, and he commanded to obey. No doubt, hearing and obeying the ruler, as the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam clarified in another hadith, he said, if a person is commanded with ma'asiyah, disobedience, فَلَا سَمَعَ وَلَا قَاعَ. There is no obedience and there is no hearing in that particular thing. If the ruler tells you, drink alcohol, you do not drink alcohol. If the ruler tells you, don't pray, you pray. If the ruler tells you, don't fast Ramadan, you fast. So where is the condoning of any evil? We reject all types of evil. From the beginning of evil to the end of evil. Rather what they want us to do, they want us to justify their methodology of what? Of rebellion and chaos and corruption. But what amazes me, they say, we say, rebellion is from the ways of the Khawarij. Because rebellion became before takfir. Those who rebelled against Uthman radiallahu anh, they never made takfir of Uthman radiallahu anh. They rebelled against him. The Khawarij. Takfir came later on. Takfir, it came later on. We believe, like the muhaqqiqoon of Ahl Sunnah, there is consensus. From the signs of the people of the Sunnah is that they do not hold the permissibility to rebel against the Muslim ruler, even if they are a Christian. Yes, we obey them in what is lawful, and we do not obey them in that which is unlawful, that which is haram. إِنَّمَا الطَّاعَ بِالْمَعْرُوفِ. Obedience is only in that which is lawful allowed. We don't obey them in ma'asiyah. But they say it's a matter of ikhtilaf, different. طيب, why do you call names? Why do you call people bootlickers when they oppose you? Is that the adab of khilaf? Is that the etiquette of differing? That when somebody, you say, we don't agree with you in that, but in accordance to what you claim, you say the scholars, they differ, Ahl Sunnah differ. We say, no, there's ijma. All you have to do is go back to the books of the Imam of the Salaf. Go back to Surah Itiqad of Al-Lalikani. Go back to Sharia of Al-Ajuri. Go back to Surah Sunnah of Imam Ahmad. Go back to Sharh al-Sunnah al-Barbahari. Go back to Aqidah Ashab al-Hadith, al-Sabuni, and other than that, from the books of the Salaf. A'immat al-Salaf. But they say it's a matter of contention. So why do you demonize those who hold a position that you believe is a valid position? Wal-iyadu billah. They want to demonize the people of the Sunnah because they know that the only people that are between them and their political objectives and them causing commotion and chaos in the Muslim lands is the people of the Sunnah. So all they have is a shatam, wasab, abuse, and insult. Na'am. With knowledge, wa lillahi alhamdul minna, wa subhanakallahu wa bihamdika, ashhadu an la ilaha illa ant, astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayk. Wa jazakumullahu khairan, wa assalamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.